if you or someone you know is trying to get pregnant, it's very important that you know that taking folic acid during pregnancy may lower the risk of your child being autistic. Now, we have with us Dr. Allison Ring, an OBGYN from Columbia St. Mary's. She's here to explain and talk about this. Thank you for being with us, Dr. Ring.
You're welcome.
First of all, tell us about how a person can get folic acid and why is it so important?
Well, we've known for many years that folic acid supplementation around the time of conception is very important in preventing neural tube defects in the children. And there was a suggestion that it was important for other neurodevelopmental disorders like autism as well. So recently there was a study that was published that showed that there was a significant decrease in autism in those in the children of the women who did take folic acid around the time of conception, and then also the first few months of pregnancy as well.
So if I'm a woman and I'm planning on getting pregnant, should I take folic acid right from the very beginning or before I even think about it?
Absolutely. You should get started on the folic acid when you start trying to conceive. And the most benefit is if you take the folic acid the month prior to conception and the first 2 months of pregnancy. And sometimes that's even before you know that you're pregnant.
And is taking the pills the only way to get folic acid? What about through your diet or nutrition?
Folic acid is found in food, including vegetables and beans and fortified grains. However, the average American will only consume about 150 micrograms of folic acid in their diet a day. And the recommended dose for a childbearing age woman is 400 micrograms. So you really do need to take a supplement in addition to what you're consuming in your diet.
Interesting. Now, should a woman continue to take it after she's had her children?
I would recommend yes to continue it, especially while they're still nursing and where there's some potential for becoming pregnant again.
Very important. Now, what about any other benefits for men? Do they need folic acid?
Well, it's suggested that there may be a benefit in thwarting heart disease, cancers, and depression as well.
So, really?
There can be some benefit to men and other women as well that aren't trying to conceive.
And as always, talk to your doctor, right?
That's right.
Okay. Absolutely. Dr. Allison Ring from Columbia St. Mary's, we appreciate you being with us this evening. Very good information.